The t-test for the mean. For example, a travel magazine reports the average price for a hotel room is $87 per night. A frequent traveler to the state of Florida believes that the average price is much higher in Miami. She sampled 7 hotels and determined the mean to be $135, with a standard deviation of $40. Is there sufficient evidence to suggest that the average price for a hotel room in Miami is greater than $87 per night at alpha equaling 0.05? For this example, we are going to perform a test of hypothesis at the 5% level of significance. Recall, there are 5 steps to testing a hypothesis. Step number 1 is stating the hypotheses. For this example, a travel magazine reports the average price for a hotel room to be $87. So using notation, we have H sub naught is equal to mu being equal to $87. Now remember to use the equal sign when writing the null hypothesis, and always ensure that mu is used whenever you're analyzing an average. A traveler believes the price is much higher in Miami. So using notation, we have the alternative hypothesis being written as mu is greater than $87. Please note that greater than is used because the traveler believes the price per night for a hotel room in Miami is higher than what is reported in the travel magazine. For step number 2, we're going to state the level of significance. And for this example, alpha is equal to 0.05. For step number 3, we're going to compute the test statistic. This example follows a t-distribution, so we'll be using the t-test statistic, and that's equal to x bar minus mu over s divided by the square root of n with degrees of freedom equaling n minus 1. So in this sample of 7 hotels, the mean was determined to be $135 with a standard deviation of $40. And so we have x bar is equal to 135, mu, which is derived from the null hypothesis, is equal to 87, and that's all over $40 divided by the square root of 7. And therefore, t is equal to 3.17. Our degrees of freedom is equal to n minus 1. And so 7 minus 1 is equal to 6. For step number 4, we're going to determine the critical value. Recall, the critical value is based on the level of significance in the direction of the alternative hypothesis. And so if we draw this out, we'll have a right tilt test because the alternative was greater than. And so we'll have area shaded to the right. And so at this point, we'll mark our location and shade to the right of that critical value. And the area in that tail is 0.05. And so since this follows a t-distribution, we're going to use the t-table to find the critical value. Here's an example of the t-distribution table. The first thing you'll want to do is locate alpha, and recall alpha was 0.05. This is the area in one tail, so you want to make sure that you select the appropriate column. Next, you'll identify the degrees of freedom, and for this example, there were 6. And so the critical value that corresponds to 0.05 in the right tail with 6 degrees of freedom is 1.94. So now that we know the critical value, we can make a decision on whether to reject or not reject the null hypothesis. If our test statistic of 3.17 falls in the rejection region, and in this case it does, we're able to reject the null hypothesis. And so our decision is to reject the null hypothesis. Since we made a decision to reject the null hypothesis, we can go ahead and state the conclusion, which is step 5. And for our conclusion, we state that there is sufficient evidence to suggest that the average price of a hotel room in Miami is greater than $87 per night.